Hello everyone, it's me, Marco from MDT, and today I have a little bit of a different topic for you. Today it's going to be all about automatic light control. You see already a few products I have in front of me, and the idea is to talk and discuss a little bit, does automatic light switching make sense? Because I still know a lot of system integrators who still really believe that using a light switch to control the light really is the only right thing to do. With my experience nowadays, I know and I really truly believe that using these presence and motion detectors gives you a huge benefit. Of course, not only that you don't have to switch the light on and off personally, but there are also other benefits that come with it. And that's what I'd like to talk about. Before we get started, just to pick up everybody, there are two different kinds of detectors. One is presence detectors. They are traditionally mounted on the ceiling and just to detect if somebody is in the room or not, even without movement. And the other version is the movement detector. With the movement detector, it detects really the movement for like for a hallway or a stairway, for example. That's where you traditionally see them and they traditionally do make sense. Now, what you see here is only some few selected products, but I would like to just go through these four examples. And if you have questions or comments, feel free to write them in the comments. Let's start with the first product that I'm already holding in my hand. I'm going to show it to the camera. You see it here. This is a presence detector that is flush mounted from us. Of course, we also have them that when they are surface mounted or ones for outside with IP44 protection, for example. But what I would like to show with this device you see here, it has three sensors in behind the cover, and you can use these sensors to detect different different spaces. Okay, da machen wir den Schnitt, ne? Okay. You can use this presence detector, for example, in a kitchen, dining room, living room. This would be the case at my home, where I have these three sensors, and I can say, okay, one is for the couch area, one is for the dining area, and maybe it was one for the space in between. So regardless of where I am in the room, I can detect, is somebody there, and turn on the light, for example. Additionally to that, the device also offers a orientation light that has inside that I can activate in the evening, for example, so I can move throughout my home or office building, wherever, and always have like a minimum on light with it. So this would be the first device that I wanted to show you. Now we're going to switch from presence detection to motion detection. And again, I'd like to show you the device in the camera. So this is a motion detector that is mounted in 1.10 meters height. You see it's very flat. Let's show you the back side of the device. And what I really like about this device is, of course, first it has two buttons that I can use any way I would like. Permanent on, permanent off, for shades or whatever. But it also detects the direction of the movement. So not only does it detect, yes, there is movement, turn the light on or off, but in a hallway, it couldn't make sense to determine is somebody coming into the room or going out of the room. So this is like a cool, unique function that this device has. So like I said, this is the version for 1.10 meters. We also have a different version for 2.20 meters for the motion detection. All right, we're gonna jump back into the presence detection. And you saw the first one that I showed you. This was the bigger one. And now we have a smaller version. I really like this one as well. So this is for one channel, this device that you see here, and just comparing it to the other one, see how small it is. So here, all you need is a 18 millimeters drill hole, which could be very, very useful, especially for customers or use cases where you would say that people don't want to see much things on the ceiling. So if it's nearly supposed to be invisible, then I think with a presence detector in this version totally makes sense. So coming back to my home, for example, an idea could be having one over the couch area, one in the kitchen area, and one in the dining area. could be an alternative. I need to think about that, if that could be something I would like to do or change in the future. All right, last but not least, this is the end boss that I would like to show you. I'd like to hold it in the camera again. Hope that you can see it. I'll just move the others away. Now, this is a presence detector like the others. By the way, I'm showing it here in the black version. All the others are also available in white and black. These are the standard colors that we do have at MDT. And this is not only a presence detector, but it also has different sensors for the air quality, VOC and CO2. Now I'm gonna come to a really, really, really cool use case. In addition to that, you see here, and the lid is also an RGB light behind it. Now I can use this for different functions as well. So let me tell you why this, I really like this device, especially for office buildings, for example, or schools. If you have, let's just stick with the school idea. Let's just say you have a school room and you have one of these presence detectors mounted on the ceiling, then it turns on and off the light and adjusts the light, all the standard functions that you would expect from a presence detector. And as a teacher, you're wondering, why are my students so tired? Why are all the heads on the table? Well, maybe because it's just simply not enough. The CO2 level is not how it should be. And I can see through this LED, like a red light, red, green, and yellow, I can see, it's time to open up the window. So even if I don't have electromechanical windows, I still see the indication through the light that something is not right and that I need to do something. So this is a very useful case, or maybe in office rooms. So everywhere where good quality of air does make sense, having that included into one device and even showing it visually is, for me, I think, a huge benefit. Now, to sum it up, I've talked about four different kinds of devices, all for different cases, and that is totally correct. So not only having one device for everything probably doesn't make sense, but having devices for different cases is what is recommended and should be adjusted just how you need it. Now, I'm going to be very interested in seeing the comments, what you write. What do you think about these different devices? Which do you prefer? What is maybe missing in your opinion? And what do you like? So I'm totally interested to see that in the comments. And if you have further questions, do not hesitate to contact us at MDT directly. All right, that's it from my side. Cheers, yours, Marco.